this year, I started getting headaches and feeling really faint. I went to the hospital and they said I had a leaky mitral valve. And so that meant that the blood flowed backwards through the heart, back into my lungs.
I had infective endocarditis. I was just stressing out more than anything because I had a feeling that everything was about to crumble.
I was really upset and they just said I needed an operation. I said to the doctor, would they be able to do it keyhole? And he said, nobody does it keyhole. And if they do, you don't have a very good outcome. After researching a little bit, I found out that wasn't true.
When I first met Gemma in my clinic, it was clear that she'd done a lot of research. She wanted her operation performed through a keyhole approach, as opposed to through the breastbone, which is the traditional procedure. Many people think, even now, the keyhole is either not possible or that it is unsafe. In actual fact, it is both possible and very safe, as long as certain criteria are met. Here at the Diagnostic Centre, we can do all of the non-invasive tests that we need to ascertain whether a patient is suitable for keyhole or not. And by the end of that day, we can actually tell them whether that's the right way forward.
We're looking at the health of the coronary arteries, we're looking at the health of the aorta, but we're also looking at the relationship of the heart structures, which will help guide the surgeon when performing the surgery and ensure that it's done with good quality and safely.
We really enjoy using the latest technology, echocardiography, which is a structure, which is Doppler, which is a blood flow inside the heart. We have tissue Doppler also, which is a motion of the walls. We have 3D echocardiography, we have contrast, and we have the assessment during stress. We use a variety of techniques to really obtain the results that we need.
We at the Keyhole Heart Clinic have been performing this operation for more than 12 years, and through that period of time, we've learned a great deal about the right types of patients to offer the surgery to, and actually, perhaps more importantly, to understand when not to offer keyhole heart surgery.
I went in and he showed me my echo, showed me what was wrong with my heart and what it should look like afterwards.
He did go through the fact that I didn't have to have big scar down my chest, that they can do a minimally invasive operation. That's when all my fears kind of calmed down.
One of the big benefits of keyhole heart surgery is that the incisions that we make are not only very small, they can be hidden, so cosmetically very appealing, but from a doctor's perspective, I'm more interested in more of the tangible benefits. We avoid breaking the breastbone. Now, if we go through the breastbone, that takes 12 weeks to heal. But many of our smaller incisions can heal in 7 or 8 days. And you can see that the time to recovery when we do operations through keyhole, particularly when it's performed by experienced teams, can lead to a very good outcome.
Mr. Birdi came to see me the day after the operation. He let me know that the surgery went smoothly. He said everything went fine and everything should be good from now on.
We bring together specialists from dietetics and nutritional therapy, along with our surgeons, our physiotherapy team, our nursing team, our cardiologists, to all work together collaboratively to bring a truly unique service under one roof.
Many patients are unaware of the additional demands that surgery places on their body. As part of the specialist team at the Keyhole Heart Clinic, we aim to nourish our patients to optimise their nutritional status and allow them to recover more quickly.
Our data has shown us that they leave hospital much sooner than the traditional breastbone patients. They bleed less, they're much less likely to get serious wound infections, and of course their recovery out of hospital is so much more swift.
I had a 6-week consultation with Mr. Birdi. He just told me everything's going really well and they couldn't be more happy with the result.
When patients have had an operation through the breastbone, they're told not to do any heavy lifting for at least 3 months. And that can really have a significant impact on people. When they've had a keyhole operation, many of them are able and ready to do things from about 2 weeks after their surgery.
A few weeks later, she went out and bought a bike. And I was really worried that she was riding around on this bike, but she was absolutely fine to do that.
Nobody could believe that I'd had an operation, and I think that I just carried on as I would have before.
6 months on, I'm feeling back to normal. I feel really comfortable in myself. Having the keyhole heart surgery means that I don't have the scar down my chest, which, I mean, I wanted to work in fashion, so that would definitely impact me. I wouldn't be able to wear anything with a V-neck. It would definitely just make me a lot more self-conscious.
before my operation, I had to have my asthma pump whenever I was doing exercise, and I don't need it at all anymore. I know I can play with my son now without getting tired and worn out, and I know that I'm going to be okay.
The team at the Keyhole Heart Clinic are striving to find new ways to offer patients treatment for their heart disease, whilst not wanting to compromise the short and the long-term outcomes of their treatment. Combining the expertise we have developed in keyhole heart surgery with some of the more traditional treatments, we're able to bespoke a treatment pathway for our patients that gives them the confidence they need to know that they're being treated by and cared for by the right team.